Since 1905, the Pennsylvania State Police has always stood against those who wish to cause harm to our fellow Pennsylvanians. Today, we stand against an enemy which we cannot see, a life-threatening health pandemic. The world that we knew has changed. Our work protocols, as well as our personal daily life settings, have been affected. We continue to deal with evolving adjustments, but the fortitude and perseverance of the Pennsylvania State Police family remains unchanged. In trying times throughout the years, our personnel have surmounted all challenges. During this new, unparalleled situation affecting our great state of Pennsylvania and the world, we will again prevail. Although we had to modify our traditional ceremony from gathering together on the Hill at the Pennsylvania State Police Academy, the importance of today remains paramount. It is a privilege to provide this message to you as we honor the memory of the 98 Pennsylvania State Police troopers who have laid down their lives to protect the citizens of this Commonwealth. While we acknowledge the ultimate sacrifice they made, it is also important to memorialize how they lived their lives. These troopers were fathers, husbands, sons, brothers, uncles, cousins, and friends. We also know that their loss was, and is to this day, extremely painful to bear. The costs have been high over the past 115 years. 98 troopers have laid down their lives rather than swerve from the path of duty. On September 2, 1906, Privates John F. Henry and Francis A. Zeringer became the first two members of the Pennsylvania State Police to sacrifice their lives as they attempted to arrest several barricaded gunmen. Even from the beginning, it was recognized that the Pennsylvania State Police was destined to be an extraordinary leader in law enforcement due to the courage and dedication of our members to face all challenges. However, 96 members have joined Privates Henry and Zeringer in their eternal watch over the department. All of these true heroes carry forth a torch of inspiration and present those of us who wear the gray with a message. A message that we bear the duty and responsibility to be faithful to their spirit and honor their sacrifice by being worthy representatives of this department. We see their service to society as footprints from the past that guide our path into the future. The pain of their separation will never be alleviated. However, we recognize that these 98 men of honor left us a long-lasting gift, the gift of hope. Hope for today, hope for tomorrow, and hope for the future. The Pennsylvania State Police has progressed over time from horseback to mobile office and electronic mail. However, the singular most important aspect that has never changed or faltered has been the spirit of the state trooper, the soldier of the law. This strength of character, which closely guards the department's core values of honor, service, integrity, respect, trust, courage, and duty, serves as a living tribute to our fallen family members. On behalf of over 6,000 men and women of the Pennsylvania State Police, we pay our solemn respect to those who have fallen. May the souls of our brothers rest in peace, and may each of you find peace and contentment on your path of life. Those who have gone before us would want nothing less. The world that we knew has changed. It is unclear what the new normal may be. But remember, what will not change is that you will always be a part of the Pennsylvania State Police family, the solid foundation for the future. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.
Good morning. I am Major Thomas DeBovey, the director here at the Bureau of Training and Education. Today is a day to reflect upon over a century of honorable service to the citizens of the Commonwealth, the 115th anniversary of the Pennsylvania State Police. Our reputation has endured because of The courage, dedication, professionalism, and personal sacrifice our men and women have made over these 115 years. 98 members of the Pennsylvania State Police gave their lives in the line of duty as the ultimate sacrifice, saving the lives of our citizens and ensuring the safety of our communities. Today, we honor those members who laid down their lives rather than swerve from the path of duty, and we keep not only them but their families and their friends in our thoughts. To the family members of those who killed in the line of duty, please know we will never forget the service or sacrifice of your loved ones. Thank you.
John F. Henry, killed in the line of duty, September 2nd, 1906. Francis A. Zeringer, September 2nd, 1906. Timothy Kelleher, September 14th, 1907. Mark A. Prynne, February 9th, 1909. John Garcia, February 21st, 1909. John L. Williams, August 22nd, 1909. Jack C. Smith, August 23rd, 1909. Robert V. Myers, March 28th, 1913. Andrew Zapp, April 28th, 1918. John F. Dargis, May 31st, 1918. Stanley W. Crist, December 1st, 1919. Ben F. McAvoy, September 21st, 1923. William J. Omler, October 25th, 1923. Francis L. Haley, October 14th, 1924. Edwin F. Haas, October 17th, 1924. Bernard S. C. McElroy, December 21st, 1924. Bertram Beach, December 10th, 1925. Claude F. Kesey, January 4th, 1927. Martin A. Hanahoe, February 27th, 1927. Thomas E. Lipka, April 3rd, 1927. John M. Thomas, May 8, 1927. John Downey, August 22, 1927. Vincent A. Hassan, December 27, 1927. Sharon C. Weibel, February 6, 1928. Andrew W. Miller, April 1, 1928. J. F. Proof, August 29, 1928. Russell T. Swanson, April 19, 1929. Wells C. Hammond, October 14, 1929. Brady C. Paul, December 27, 1929. Thomas E. Lawry, January 31, 1930. Arthur A. Copenhaver, July 13, 1930. Charles L. Stewart, July 18, 1930. Thomas B. Elder, March 22, 1931. Timothy G. McCarthy, May 12, 1931. Orville A. Mooring, December 11, 1931. Joseph A. Conrad, September 6, 1932. Charles E. Householder, August 20, 1933. Herbert P. Brantlinger, September 3, 1933. James A. Seary, September 10, 1934. Floyd W. Madeira, December 11, 1934. Joseph L. Fulton, June 4, 1936. Joe B. Champion, July 15, 1936. J. Lee Clark, March 1, 1937. John E. Fessler, April 23, 1937. Joseph A. Hoffer, April 27, 1937. John J. Broski, August 14, 1937. John D. Simonson, December 1, 1937. Joseph M. Williams, October 8, 1938. Charles H. Craven, October 11, 1938. George D. Naughton, January 30, 1939. Frederick J. Sutton, January 3, 1940. George J. Yasher, April 1, 1940. Thomas P. Carey, June 17, 1941. Dean N. Ziegler, October 17, 1942. John A. Ditkowski, July 24, 1950. Floyd B. Klaus, November 2, 1953. Joseph F. McMillan, May 13, 1956. Philip C. Melly, November 3, 1957. Charles S. Stansky, January 23, 1958. Edward McHugh, May 31, 1958. Stephen R. Gerke, August 24, 1958. Francis M. Tessitore, August 5, 1960. Anthony Bench, October 3, 1961. Edward W. Gundel, March 18, 1962. Richard G. Barnhart, August 8, 1964. Gary R. Rosenberger, December 12, 1970. John S. Valent, December 9, 1971. Robert D. Lapp, Jr., October 16, 1972. Bruce C. Rankin, April 25, 1973. Ross E. Snowden, January 17, 1974. Leo M. Kaselnik, August 15, 1977. Joseph J. Welsh, September 13, 1977. Wayne C. Ebert, June 7, 1978. Albert J. Izzo, June 13, 1979. David D. Monahan, April 17, 1980. Herbert A. Werfel, February 7, 1982. William R. Evans, January 6, 1983. Frank J. Bowen, October 26, 1983. Gary W. Fisher, February 3, 1985. John J. Brown, February 14, 1985. Rourke H. Ross, May 15, 1986. Clinton W. Crawford, August 17, 1987. John A. Andrulevich, May 9, 1988. Wayne D. Billheimer, April 12, 1989. Paul Almer, April 12, 1989. Arthur L. Hershey, January 3, 1999. Matthew R. Bond, January 14, 2000. Todd C. Kelly, November 7, 2001. Joseph J. Sepp, Jr., November 10, 2002. Brian A. Patterson, February 14, 2003. Joseph R. Bacorny, Jr., December 12, 2005. Joshua D. Miller, June 7, 2009. Paul G. Ritchie, January 13, 2010. Blake T. Coble, October 4, 2012. Brian K. Dixon II, September 12, 2014. David Kedra, September 30, 2014. Landon E. Weaver, December 30, 2016. Michael P. Stewart III, July 14, 2017.